Today, I'm going to share a quick update on the latest robotic project that I've been working on. So this is a self-balancing robotic platform. It is slightly bigger and heavier than the previous machine that I have constructed. Now, when completed, this will be roughly about 4 kilograms in weight. So there is the self-balancing platform on the bottom. The upper body contains a pair of mechanical arms. Each arm has 3 degrees of freedom. I'm using a smart servo to drive each joint of the arms. There's also a smart servo on the middle of the upper body. Subsequently, I'm going to add a robotic head to this smart servo. And when I complete it, I hope to add a gripper on the end of each arm. Let me just turn on the robot. So for this version, I also incorporate a multicolor LED onto the front panel. So this multicolor LED will be used to show the status of the machine, and also it will be a very useful troubleshooting tool when I'm developing the software for the robot. Let me just put the robot upright. Okay, so now it's self-balancing. I'm going to connect this robot to my computer. The robot has a built-in Bluetooth wireless transceiver, so I'm just using a Bluetooth protocol to communicate with a simple software on my computer. So this software can monitor the sensor status and send some simple command to the machine. Let me just connect. Okay, now it's connected. You can see that the color of the front panel LED will change to slightly bluish when it's connected to an external computer. I'm going to now ask the robot to perform some simple action on the arms. Now I'm going to turn the robot 180 degrees. So this is the back of the machine. You can see the individual smart servo. This is a compartment where I place the inertial measurement unit sensor and also the Bluetooth transceiver module. Here we can see the lithium polymer battery. I'm using a 11.1 volts 5000 mAh capacity battery. At the bottom we can see 2 pieces of gear DC motor. This gear DC motor, these are 37 mm in diameter, and they come with a Hall effect sensor at the end so that we can monitor the rotation of the motor shaft. Okay, now I'm going to turn the robot back facing the front. Let me open the front cover so that we can see the wiring and the circuit board behind the front panel. There, the front cover is removed. So at the bottom, this is a off-the-shelf DC motor driver circuit board. You can also see a pair of proximity infrared sensor that I installed at the bottom. So the proximity infrared sensor will help the robot to detect obstacle in front of the wheels. Of course, subsequently the head will also have a camera to detect obstacle, but sometimes the camera cannot see right underneath, beneath the wheels. So here we will still need to rely on this proximity infrared sensor. At the middle, we can see this is the custom design robotic controller board. The heart of this robotic controller is a DSPIC33C microcontroller from Microchip technology. The controller is running at 200 MHz. The top, this piece of circuit board is a custom design smart servo shield. So this smart servo shield captures the full duplex serial data from the robotic controller and convert the full duplex serial data packet into a half duplex format. And then this will be sent to the individual smart servo. Okay, now let me just connect, put back the front cover. Right, there you go. Let me just disconnect the robot from my computer. So I hope to continue to have the time to work on this machine. If I have any new updates, I will post it on my channel. Thank you for watching.